It's quiet right now for the most part, but still look out to our west. Complex of showers and a couple of thunderstorms. Those could sneak in, especially to the west and north as the night goes on, but it's not going to be an all-night rain, and this is not going to be a severe weather event. Speaking of which, tomorrow we're going to heat the atmosphere up, and then we're going to have a low pressure with a cool front sweeping its way through. And the way it looks right now, the severe weather risk is going to be to our south. Slight risk there of seeing some hail, some wind, downpours. I'm not expecting a widespread severe weather outbreak here, but still we'll have to watch as the day goes on, see how things pan out. Still, it looks like you're going to be seeing some showers and storms as the day goes on tomorrow, especially. So 75, that's what our average high should be. And it all depended on where you live today. And you noticed if you live by Lake Michigan, it was a lot colder. But look to the south of that front. And Chicago at 78 degrees, 83 in Des Moines. I think upper 70s for a lot of us tomorrow, maybe even a couple of 80s, especially to the south and west. And currently, no 80s on the map. And it all depends on where you live. Look if you're by Lake Michigan, 55 in Sturgeon Bay, but you head to the west, warmer and warmer temperatures. Appleton, you're sitting at 70. Same with Oshkosh. It's not that bad of a day, but it sure doesn't feel very summer-like because the dew points aren't that high. You got only dew points in the 40s. Well, that's pretty dry air. But notice, off to our south, there is more humidity. Dew points into the middle 60s. Eventually, those get here. We're going to have a little bump tomorrow, but I think the more humid air especially gets here as we head into Tuesday. Get to that in a little bit. Satellite and radar, we are quiet. Again, we could see a shower or a thunderstorm, especially to the west and to the north tonight as the night goes on. Slight chances to the east. And then tomorrow, this low pressure with the warm front and then a cool front going to come sweeping on through as the day goes on. So some daytime heating, more ingredients to pop up some showers and, of course, some thunderstorms. Again, looks like the severe threat stays to our south, but still looks like as the day goes on, some showers and a couple of thunderstorms. Now, here we go as the night goes on. Notice the better chance of seeing rain going to be to our west and to our north. But still, as tomorrow wears on, here comes the low, warm front, cool front. That's probably going to be kicking off some showers and thunderstorms, especially in the afternoon, the way it looks right now. But again, timing with these, especially when you have a warm front hanging around, you have to see what kind of develops along that. Now, as we go into tomorrow night, any shower or thunderstorm going to pretty much diminish, then we're going to have one quiet day. And then this next system going to get closer and closer again. It's going to bring up our humidity, but probably be bringing us some showers and storms. But tonight, maybe a storm late, especially to the west and to the north, 51 degrees, slight chances to the east. Sunday, showers and storms developing as the day goes on. It's going to be a windy one, so not one of the nicest days for doing any sort of boating. As far as Sunday night, chance of storms, then it's going to be clearing out, 68 degrees. And then Monday, well, there's that sun again, 82, warming it up. It doesn't look like it's going to be that humid. As we head throughout the next 10 days, what are we looking at? An unsettled week, Tuesday all the way through Friday. Temperatures around 80 degrees, mid to upper 70s, and we'll probably be kicking up the humidity. Now, Cassandra, I'm not saying a steady rain all week, but still, we'll see a couple rounds of storms rolling on through.